Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Alibaba, which released over 100 new open-source artificial intelligence models and text-to-video feature in an intensified AI push. New York-listed shares of the Chinese tech giant surged 4%. Also in focus, shares of Comax following an upgrade from UBS from neutral to buy. Shares of the Swiss machinery company jumped 6%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Ocado after the British retailer reported a 15% year-on-year increase in retail revenue. This sent its stock higher by 7%.
Asian markets ended Thursday trade higher following the Fed's outsized rate cut. Japan's Nikkei 225 jumped 2%, while Australia's ASX 200 hit a record high. The South Korean KOSPI saw a modest gain as it returned to trade after a long mid-autumn holiday. The Hong Kong Hang Seng, also returning from a holiday, climbed 2% as the city's central bank moved in lockstep with the Fed and cut its key rate by 50 basis points to 5.25%. Philippine shares joined the rally, with the main index breaching the 7,200 level.
As long as we do not have any substantial negative event that will really disrupt the market, then of course we will not revisit any more below 7,000 level. The 50 BPS cuts is quite a surprise, but so I guess most of what the market had really factored in revolves in a quarter BPS cut.
But
I guess that is why we still believe that we can see the market rallying up until now.
Here at home, an economist sees more foreign investments coming to the Philippines following the Fed's decision to cut rates. RCBC chief economist Mike Ricafort believes the narrowing interest rate differential between the BSP and the Fed will prompt more foreign investors to look towards Manila. He adds there's a good chance a Philippine central bank will match the Fed's move in the coming years.
Now, given the fact that our interest differential is the narrowest ever, it's a positive signal, 75 to 100 basis points, especially the 75 basis points. That's the narrowest in our lifetimes, meaning to say the confidence of international investors have increased over the years. They're just willing to have that premium of 75 basis points to 100 basis points to invest here in the Philippines now at 6.25. And now the U.S. is down to 5%. So that's a good sign. It is a pro-growth monetary policy because it's prioritizing growth, trying to maximize optimize the easy monetary policy or relatively lower interest rates to help stimulate more business and economic activities.
Around 158 new hotels valued at 250 billion pesos are being developed in the Philippines. That's according to the 2024 Philippine Accommodation Pipeline Report of Lichu Property Consultants and the Philippine Hotel Owners Association. Lichu Director Alfred Lay says the projects are expected to produce around 40,000 room keys and generate 57,000 direct jobs. He adds a number of hotels in development can be attributed to large developers and lifestyle developers entering the market. He believes this reflects optimism in the long-term growth of the country's tourism industry.
I think it's important to know that these commitments for the 40,000 room keys and the 158 hotels happened during a relatively high interest rate environment. As you mentioned, the news of interest rate cuts coming through, I think that is only going to bode well for new projects to come up. And we already expect to see several announcements in the coming months of new hotels that will be committed by the hotel developers.